Hello and welcome to the episode 64 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. A fruitful recording session, a drink with old money, and a collaboration with Maurice Gibb of BG's are among the highlights of today's episode. On the 5th of March 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, played a concert in their drummer's cellar. You'll recognize the venue by now. It was the Casbah Coffee Club in Liverpool. Double feature in 1962 with the usual two-hour lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool and an evening performance in the Kingsway Club in Southport, the fifth time the Beatles, still featuring Pete Best on drums, graced that stage. In 1963, the lads, now with Ringo Starr on the drummer's seat, had a photo session in the area close to the EMI Manchester Square main offices. The band, with EMI staff photographer John Dove, weren't just looking for good publicity shots, but also for something that could be good for an LP cover. In the afternoon, the lads were back in Studio 2 in Abbey Road to record their new single, Thank You Girl, initially called Thank You Little Girl, with From Me to You as a B-side. Yes, you heard that right. During the course of the recording session, started at 2:30 and going on until 9 p.m. instead of being broken in the two booked slots of 2:30 to 5:30 p.m. and 7 to 10 p.m., the band finished both songs with 13 takes for each one, including false starts and edit pieces. It was only then, on hearing the playback of the finished results, that everyone realized that From Me to You was a catchier, overall better piece. It was then decided to flip the songs, with From Me to You becoming the single and Thank You Girl on the B-side. The band also wanted to tape two more songs, What Goes On and the one after 909. There was only time to record one of them, though, and the Beatles decided to try the latter, a piece dating back to the earliest days of the Lennon-McCartney songwriting partnership, probably from around 1956. Five takes of one after 909 were completed, but the work was considered unsatisfactory and the song lay dormant until the Get Back sessions. What Goes On would not be recorded until the Rubber Soul sessions in 1965. Do you want to make this or my other music-related series even better? You can do worse than visit www.simonmas.com/support and see what you can do to, well, support my work. No donation is too small, and even simply making other people aware of my content on the web can make a world of difference. Be fab and help me to put more and more music history, theory tutorials, musicological narratives on the internet for free. Thank you. On the 5th of March 1964, the Beatles were busy on the set of A Hard Day's Night, boarding their rented train at Acton Main Line and travelling between London and Taunton to complete various train sequences for the film. After the shooting, they jumped down at Westbourne Park and had drinks with Geoffrey Archer, Sir Noel Hall, their manager Brian Epstein, and others at the Oxford Sportsman's Club, supporting the fundraising for Oxfam's 21st anniversary celebration organized by Archer. Nothing much can be said for the 1965 day of filming for Help. The Fab Four were shot on various locations in New Providence, Bahamas, with John, Paul, and George shouting Ringo while looking for him. Let's close with the 1970 studio session for Ringo Starr's Sentimental Journey LP at the Morgan Studios in London. A 36-piece orchestra recorded two songs for the album, with Ringo overdubbing his vocals. The orchestra was conducted by Ron Goodwin for his arrangement of Whispering Grass and by Maurice Gibb of the Bee Gees for his version of Bye Bye Blackbird. The session was completed between 10 a.m. and 1 p.m. And this concludes today's episode. Tomorrow we will talk about the Beatles' last single. Curious? Then you need to turn in again for more. For the moment, I wish you a good day. and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.